On December the 6th, 1980, the nuclear-powered attack aircraft carrier USS Nimitz, with a crew of 5,000 men and a strike force of 90 aircraft, was on a routine mission in the Pacific when it encountered a storm unlike any ever recorded and disappeared.
Captain, we're down across the board. Antennas check out, but we're off the air.
Any word from our destroyers?
We aren't getting anything except some code transmissions in the 200-meter band. Otherwise, we're dead as a doornail.
Op, what's our radar picture?
Radar shows us clear, sir.
Can't you see that Russian trawler?
I have the signal officer on deck, but no visual sightings, sir.
All of us know that movement through time is possible. Einstein proved there are forces in the universe which we're only now just beginning to understand. I mean understand through science, not superstition. There are black holes in space, antimatter, curved space. Things that are as strange to us as electricity would have been to people in the Middle Ages, or this ship in World War II.
Happening here? Who are you people?
Are we at war? Is that what happened?
Splash the zeros. I say again, splash the zeros.
We've got an incredible opportunity here. We know where all the mistakes are going to be made for the next 40 years, and you've got the power to correct them.
I've got planes out there.
Those planes give us all a second chance. We're a bunch of damn fools if we don't take it.
Those men have enough knowledge among them to build the atom bomb. Reach the moon years before it should have happened.
Is that a terrifying prospect, Captain? Or a tempting one?
On December the 6th, 1980, the nuclear carrier USS Nimitz disappeared in the Pacific and reappeared December 6th, 1941, off the coast of Pearl Harbor. The final countdown is about to begin.
Swim for thousands of miles upstream just to spawn. Male elk will engage in fierce battles for the opportunity.